Hi students, today we are starting with noise pollution. It is undesirable higher level of sound in India. The Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act came into force in 1881 but was amended in 1987 to include the noise as art air pollutant. Noise measurement sound is expressed in decibel, that is dB. A sound of over 115 dB is very harmful for ears. Prolonged exposure to noise level above 80 dB leads to permanent hear loss. Causes are use of loudspeakers in music system, industries, factories, noises, etc. Harmful effects are sleeplessness, stress, increased heartbeat, breathing problem, damage to eardrum, etc. Control methods: by applying sound absorbent material or by muffling noise in industrial units. Delimitation of horn free zones around hospitals and schools. Strict laws for permissible sound levels of crackers and loudspeakers should be allowed. Loudspeakers should be played up to a fixed time only. Now, water pollution. It is an undesirable change in the physical, chemical or biological properties of water that may affect the human beings and aquatic species. The Government of India has passed the Water Pollution Control Act, that is 1974, to safeguard our water resources. Now, we are talking about sources of water pollution. Domestic sewage include everything that comes from residential area to common public system. Now, composition of domestic sewage. Suspended solid substances, example sand, silt and clay. Colloidal material, example fecal matter, bacteria, cloth and paper fibers. Dissolved materials, that is nutrient, etc. It mainly contains biodegradable organic waste which are readily decomposed with the help of decomposers. Industrial wastes are released by petroleum, paper, manufacturing metals, etc. It contains heavy metals like mercury and many organic compounds. Now, effect of water pollution. Now, we'll see. This is biomagnification of DDT. DDT, dichloro, diphenyl, trichloroethane. In water, you can see here, DDT is 0.003. PPB, this is PPM, this is PPM, this is also particular per minute, this is water, DDT amount, zooplankton, DDT amount 0.04, small fish, DDT amount 0.5, large fish, DDT amount 2, and here 5. Means whatever amount of DDT is sprayed in the plants, in water it will take 0.003, then the plants which are present in water, there it will take 0.04, then small fishes are dependent on these plants, so they will absorb 0.5, large fishes are dependent on small fishes, so they absorb 5. Now, biological magnification can be defined as increase in the concentration of toxicants at successive trophic level. Mercury and DDT are well known for biological magnification. Toxic material cannot be metabolized or excreted. Therefore, they get accumulated in an organism and pass on to high trophic level. DDT accumulates in birds and disturbs calcium metabolism, which result in thinning of eggshell. This result in decline of bird population. Eutrophication can be defined as the natural aging of a lake by nutrient enrichment of its water. Now, process of eutrophication. Water in young lake is cold and clear to support life. Gradually, with this time, it gets enriched with nutrients as nitrogen and phosphorus. Due to this, aquatic life flourish in the lake. Organic remains deposit at the bottom of the lake, and with time, water becomes warmer. Eventually, floating plants develop in the lake, finally converting it into land. This accelerated aging of lakes due to sewage, agriculture, industrial waste is called cultural or accelerated eutrophication. बायोलॉजिकल ऑक्सीजन डिमांड इज अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन रिक्वायर्ड फॉर माइक्रोबियल ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ बायोडिग्रेडेबल ऑर्गेनिक मैटर एंड इट इज़ हायर इन पॉल्यूटेड वाटर एंड लेसर इन क्लीन वाटर. नाउ दिस इज डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्लो सीवेज डिस्चार्ज. दिस इज कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. दिस इज बायोलॉजिकल ऑक्सीजन डिमांड एंड दिस इज डिजॉल्व ऑक्सीजन. देन वी विल सी हेयर इट इज अपियरेंस and here reappearance of clean water. Here because of more concentration, because of sewage, this water is getting dirty, and due to increased oxygen demand, then again water will be clear. Algal bloom is excessive growth of planktonic, that is free floating alga, in the aquatic bodies. In domestic sewage, nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus favors the growth of algal bloom. It causes fish mortality and deterioration of water quality. Example, excessive growth of water, that is hyacinth, that is Eucornea crassips. It is the most problematic aquatic weeds, which is also called terror of Bengal. It grows abundantly in eutrophic water bodies and imbalances water system. A case study, that is integrated wastewater management. It includes and it can be treated in an integrated manner by utilizing a mix of artificial and natural process. One such example is town of Areta, situated along northern coast of California. An integrated wastewater treatment process was developed with the help of biologist from Humboldt University in this town. The cleaning occurs in two steps. The conventional sedimentation, filtration and chlorine treatment is carried out. The treated water still contains lots of heavy metals and other toxic pollutants. In second step, alga, fungi and bacteria are grown in marshland through which water flowed. These life forms neutralize, absorbs and assimilate the pollutants and purify the water naturally. The marshes also constitute a sanctuary with a high level of biodiversity. Eco-scan toilets have been developed in the area of Kerala and Sri Lanka for ecological sanitation. The advantages of ecological sanitation are a practical, hygienic and efficient method of disposal, cost-effective approach. Human excreta can be recycled into natural fertilizer to reduce need of chemical fertilizer. Today, whatever I have taught you, I am sending you its PDF. Thank you.